6 minute vocabulary
from bbclearningenglish.com.
Hi, I'm Finn.
And I'm Catherine, and welcome to 6 minute vocabulary. Today we're talking about false friends.
But false friends aren't people.
No.
False friends are words that look or sound the same in two different languages, but have different meanings in each language.
That's right. And today we'll give you plenty of examples.
There will be a quiz, of course.
And we'll also bring you a top tip for remembering these words.
But first, here's Jim. He works as a student advisor, and he's talking about students' problems.
While you're listening to Jim, try to guess what the student called Camilla's problem really was.
Lots of students come to me with their problems, but sometimes I have to guess what they mean. Klaus from Germany asked me for a rat because his father was busy in the kitchen. Simone, who's French, was worried about the buttons on her face. Camilla from Spain didn't know what to do because she was embarrassed. And when I helped Pierre, he said, "Thank you very much. That's terrible."
So, did you guess what Camilla's problem really was?
And the answer is Camilla was actually pregnant. But she used the wrong word when she said she was embarrassed.
She did, because embarrassed is a false friend in Spanish and English. The Spanish word embarazada means pregnant. Apologies for my Spanish pronunciation there.
I'm sure it wasn't too bad, Finn.
Spanish-speaking people need to be very careful before they tell someone they're embarrassed or that their husband is. Listen out for more false friends in this clip.
Klaus from Germany asked me for a rat because his father was busy in the kitchen. Simone, who's French, was worried about the buttons on her face.
So I'm guessing that Klaus didn't really want a rat.
I don't think so. I think he wanted some advice from Jim. The German word rat means advice in English. And Klaus was worried because his father was in prison. The word kitchen can mean prison in German.
Confusing. Mm. And what about Simone, who said, talking of confusing, Simone said she had buttons on her face.
Indeed. In French, the word bouton means spots. So Simone thought that the English word buttons had the same meaning.
OK, now let's have another clip. Pierre also said something quite strange.
And when I helped Pierre, he said, "Thank you very much. That's terrible."
So, do you think that Jim was upset when Pierre said that? After all, Jim was trying to help.
Well, Pierre didn't mean to be rude, but in French, terrible, like terrible, can have two meanings. It can mean very bad, but it can also mean great. It depends on the sound of your voice when you say it. Pierre meant that Jim's advice was great, not terrible.
Wow. Big misunderstanding, eh?
Absolutely.
So the message is, don't get upset if someone from another country says something that seems a bit strange or perhaps rude, because they might just be using a word that's a false friend.
Exactly. And be very careful yourself when you're speaking in another language. You know,
yes.
There's this one time I was in a hotel in France and I asked for a cushion.
Right.
I thought that meant a cushion for my bed.
Yes.
But it sounded like the French word couchon.
Oh.
Which means pig.
So you asked for a pig for your bedroom.
Oh, I always need a pig in my bed. Yeah.
6 minute vocabulary
from bbclearningenglish.com.
And it's time for a quiz. And today we're going to play a guessing game. So, number one, if a French man is holding some £10 notes in his hand, but he says he's got no money, what does he mean?
Well, the answer is that he means he's got no coins. Yes, monnaie in French means coins or change.
Very good. And number two, if a German woman in an English restaurant says that she wants to become a steak, Is she joking or does she really want to turn into a meal?
Well, the answer is neither. Bekommen in German is a false friend for become in English. She means that she wants to get a steak to eat.
Right then. So, number three. If someone from the US invites you to a party, Finn, and tells you to wear pants, should you be shocked?
Well, actually, no, you shouldn't. Pants in American English means trousers. It doesn't mean underwear, like in British English.
That's a relief. And that's the end of the quiz. Well done if you got them all right. And before we go, here's a vocabulary tip. Keep a note of false friends between your language and English. You could use word cards with the word on one side and the information with example sentences on the other.
And there's more about this at bbclearningenglish.com. Join us again soon for more 6-minute vocabulary. Bye.
Bye.